you're watching this video, it's because you want to learn how to play Dwarf Fortress, a highly enjoyable but also highly complex game without spending 3 hours reading the wiki or watching tutorials. The bad news is, we can't tell you everything about how to play Dwarf Fortress in 5 minutes. The good news is that in Dwarf Fortress, losing is inevitable and fun. And the best way to learn is to get started failing. Feel free to pause the video at any point because we're gonna be moving fast. We've already wasted 20 seconds, so let's dig into what you have to know to get started. To begin with, you're going to want to download the Lazy Noob Pack. The link is in the description. Unzip and open the folder you just downloaded and click on the Starter Pack Launcher. Once it's open, click this button until it reads, Aquifers, no! Don't worry about anything else because we don't have time right now! Click that beautiful Play Dwarf Fortress button and get ready for failure. I mean fun! Click Create New World, press Escape to continue, then click Y. It'll take a few minutes for the world to generate, so feel free to make yourself a sandwich. When it's done, hit Enter, make yourself another sandwich, and then select Start Playing. Select Dwarf Fortress and wait some more. Make yourself a salad this time! Now you get to pick where in the world your dwarves will build your fort. Moving around this screen is weird. You choose the area with the arrow keys, and then choose the site within that area using U, H, K, and M. Don't worry too much about getting it exactly right the first time, but generally you want a stream and some trees. Next, hit E to embark and the Play Now option. There will be a pause and then you'll be given the intro text and the name of your fort. Hit Enter and that takes you here. Congratulations! You're playing Dwarf Fortress, and we still have 3 minutes left! You're looking straight down on your dwarves and your embark site. If you want to see more of the map, you can move your view using the arrow keys. You can pause and unpause the game with the spacebar. Also, keep in mind that the game is paused while you are in menus. Dwarves like to dig, which means you're going to want to see under the ground. Using the greater than and less than keys, you can go up and down in levels. Try moving up and down a few times and watching things like trees and hills to get a sense of how the map works. If you get lost, just hit F1 to return to your starting point. And if you find yourself buried too deep in a menu or screen, hitting escape enough times will bring you back to the main screen. If you have a hill on your map, you can designate an area to be dug by pressing D twice. Place the yellow X on one corner of the rectangle you want to designate and press Enter. Move the X to the other corner of the rectangle and press Enter again. A rectangle will be highlighted and a miner will start to dig out this area once you exit the designation menu and unpause the game with space. If you don't have a hill, you're going to want to dig down. Press D to get to the designation menu and then J for dig down stair. Designate a small square on the surface, then go down one level, remember those greater than less than keys, and hit I to dig an up down stair. Be sure you designate it to be dug directly under your down stair. Now you can use D to dig halls and rooms off of your stairway. It's time to make some stuff, but first you'll need materials to make it with. Go back to the surface, select D and then T, and draw a box around some trees with the X. If you've done it right, you'll see the tree trunks you've designated to be chopped change color. From the main screen, select B to get to the build menu, and then W to see all the workshops you can build. Let's start by hitting C for a carpenter's workshop. Tell the game where you want the workshop built and select the materials you want to use. Return to the main menu and wait for your dwarves to construct it. Once it's built, hit Q and put your cursor over the workshop. Hit A to add a new task, and then hit B to ask your dwarves to make a bed. You'll see a dwarf come to the workshop and build your bed. Now you can use the B build menu and select B for bed. Select the bed you want to use, then tell your dwarves where to put it. The dwarves will put the bed down, but they still won't sleep in it, so hit the Q again to move your cursor over the bed and select R to make a bedroom. Use the plus and minus keys to make it the size you want. Now press D to make it into a dormitory so the dwarves will share the bed. You can build more beds in your dormitory if you don't want some of your dwarves sleeping on the floor. Your dwarves don't have anything to eat, but that's not important right now because what they really need is something to drink. Dwarves will drink water if they have to, but they'd much rather have booze. Let's start by building a farm plot. Press B and then P. Instead of painting your farm plot corner to corner, you size it using the U, H, K, and M keys and move it around with the arrow keys. Place your farm in some dirt underground, and once a dwarf has come to build it, use Q to look at it. Let's grow some plump helmets! Now build a still from the workshop menu. When construction is finished, select it with Q and hit A to add new task. Then pick Brew Drink from Plant. Next, hit R to have them repeat brewing until they run out of materials. There's a decent chance that something has already gone wrong. That's okay! Poke around and try things that seem interesting. When you inevitably run into a problem or error message you don't understand, Google is your friend and the Dwarf Fortress community is incredibly helpful. Congratulations, you're well on your way to your first catastrophic failure. But that's okay, because in Dwarf Fortress, losing is fun.